Meet Morgan, a 7-year-old Camelot macaw hatched with a deformity that caused her to get passed from home to home until she landed with my good friend Patty. Together, we are transforming her life and training her for the freedom of outdoor flight. This is her journey.
You feel about it, but I would like to go back to flying in this area.
Mm-hmm, okay.
To keep her super enthusiastic, because this is just her favorite flight.
Okay, that's a good idea.
Yeah, so I think mentally, for her, she's just going to be so excited and overrun by the excitement of doing this flight that it's going to make it just way easier for you guys to, like, yeah, so that way you can get comfortable in the space. And don't feel like you're just stuck in the corner. You can move closer, you can move to the sides, like both, you use the whole area, right?
Okay.
But definitely start here on like the first or second flight.
Okay. When I went in to see her earlier, I had nothing in my hands, no target, no treats.
Yeah.
And she was on the other side of the cage, and I just said, "Hey, Morgan, how you doing?" And she hurried over just to sit next to me.
Good.
Yeah.
Hey, guys. So based on how the training sessions have been going with Morgan and Patty, we've decided to cut it back from 2 sessions per day to 1 really awesome session per day and keep it shorter. So, yeah, you guys are going to kind of learn how I train clients. I often ask them certain questions and I let them make decisions, and then I go with their decision even if I disagree, so that they can figure it out, so they can make the right decisions in the future. And I kind of feel like they won't learn the lesson unless they, I guess, experience the consequence. So that was kind of the thing. In the beginning I started with asking Patty if she thought in the very beginning we should start with 2 sessions a day or 1, and she picked 2. So that's what we did, and it was the wrong choice, and so now we're to 1, and I think we're going to be really set up for success today. And I kind of came to a point where I couldn't let her make any more bad decisions, so I've asked her still and let her make the decision, but then I bring her to the correct one before the action is taken. So I'm excited for you guys to see today's session.
You ready? Good girl. Good girl. You want to do some more? Let me get one. You ready? Come here. Good girl.
I did it again. Rock. Get down.
Good girl.
Yes, no?
Yeah, it's looking great. Okay. Remember that you can hold her foot. So, like, as soon as she lands, hold.
I thought I did.
No, it was up the whole time. Oh,
yeah. Okay.
Good girl.
Good.
Come on. Good girl.
So try to make it a little bit more level when you set her down, because right now you're doing it at an angle and her bad foot is first. So if she goes down on that foot, I think she's a little bit off. So just try to make it more level so she could choose to go with the good foot.
Okay.
If she wanted.
Okay.
It might make a difference.
Ready?
Oh.
You ready, Freddy? Who's had a sneeze? You ready? Come on. Come on, you can do it, good girl. Good girl.
There you go.
There we go.
Good,
yeah,
girl.
That was much better.
Good girl. Alright, good job.
Good, yeah. You're noticing the difference? How easy she's stepping off with more level?
Yep.
Perfect.
You ready? Set. Come on! Come on! Yes! Good
Let me get that before you put her down. So she doesn't swipe it with her tail.
get a commit. You want it? You have to get off. Good girl. No, that's too short. That's just like cheating. Rough. Rough. You ready? Come on, Mr. Little One. Come on. Come on. Come on. Oh, yeah, good girl. Ready? Come on. Come on. Look at what I got. Come on, you can do it. Come on. Come on.
Remember where to place the encouragement. So the encouragement goes when she's showing that she already wants to come.
Not over there. We do it over here.
Just listening to her.
Come on. You ready? Come on, Morgan. Come on. Good girl.
Yes. That's the difference with the where to place the encouragement.
Okay,
so when she's already going, it encourages her to respond faster.
Right.
Whereas if you say it when she has no intention,
yeah, it's just
it's worthless.
Yeah, it's like beating a dead horse.
Oh,
good girl! I did not even have to ask you.
Good job being ready. That was great. Yeah, she's very talkative.
Yes. Good girl. This feels so much better today.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness.
And you're in charge, so do whatever you feel she's giving you.
Good girl. And I'm kind of thinking not too much more.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Very good. Yeah. I was thinking the same.
Hey! Look, the treats are over here now. Ooh. Wanna do one for me? Just one?
I'm gonna move in case I'm the distraction.
You want to come get a treat? All right. Look what I got. It's going to be yummy. It's a big one.
Good language.
Come on.
Yep, more.
Come on.
More. More, more, more.
Come on, Marvin. Good girl,
good
yay!
Good job.
All right. How about if I target her a little bit and call it?
Cool, I'm good with that.
Good job. Good job.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. Good run. So remember, if she sees the target stick, she's gonna constantly follow it.
Yeah.
So if you wanna restart, yeah. Just make sure it doesn't come across teasing, otherwise it's all good. She's super excited about this.
Right here. Good girl. Oh, what a good girl. Okay. She's following me. I'm
she's following you anyway. But it's good if she can't see it because then it's less taunting.
Good girl. All right. You done? You want to go back?
Rock.
Okay, so. Good girl. Say bye-bye, Jamie. Bye-bye.
See ya.
Okay, you're such a good girl. I'm going to feed her while I'm in here.
Okay.
Way better.
Yeah.
Way better. You can shut that if you want. It's not loud.
You're so loud. Yeah, way better.
Yeah.
You were like aware of everything, and just when you like barely started to stray, like I'm telling you, it was minuscule, but it was a little bit, and I just want it to become like
so
very,
I don't let it like
yeah, okay. Yeah, because I felt like if I didn't say something, it might eventually. So it was really good.
Well, you know, I did what I said I was going to do, and I wasn't thinking about it. I just
good.
Put my hand up the way I know is natural to catch a bird.
Yeah,
and I didn't worry about her foot or whatever. And
it literally felt like you were just interacting with your bird.
It
do you know
felt
what
like
I mean?
That to me too, for the first time.
Yeah, because I was just like, when I've thought about it, I'm like, I know how she is around her birds, and she's so much more natural than.
Well, it was work.
Husband.
I mean, it was. It felt like work.
A job.
It was like
almost.
You know, you assigned me a job, and I was doing it. And you were trying. But yeah, it felt good.
Good. That was great. You called it at the right time. I was wondering and waiting for you to call it. I wasn't going to, so that was perfect.
Good.
Like, I'm waiting for you to initiate everything.
Okay.
That's what I want. Like, everything you did was great. You moved around. You read that she wasn't comfortable with that. You moved back. Like, so I think you guys starting here and then finding your comfort level and moving out is really, really key.
Yeah.
I think it'll be really good for you guys.
And she seemed much more at ease about the whole thing, and I didn't sense any reluctance or...
Yeah. No, and this is, like, her zone.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
she loves this. This was, like, one session. She was excited.
Mm-hmm.
She had had all the previous, like, yay, you're awesome from target training, because you see how excited she gets for target training.
Yeah.
She just loves it.
Yeah.
So the fact that I think you did that twice today...
Mm-hmm.
And then went into the session, she was like, heck yeah, I want to interact with you, you know?
Yep.
So built it up, and then you guys were set up for success for this one session.
It felt good. It felt the way I expected it to.
You wanted it too.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you good keeping this model for a while?
Yeah. Yeah.
The target training in the morning,
you know,
target training, one session.
Yep.
Cool.
And we will keep it maybe stray a little bit here and there and see, you know.
Yeah. What I'd like
start
to see
here
is,
and then I'll
is
try
you
to...
expand.
Yeah.
You need to expand.
Okay,
yeah. And if you want to use a T-stand, if you want to use the back of the chair, you don't have to set her down here every time. You can set her down here. You can set her down on the T-stand and move it over here. You can do whatever you feel.
Right. Okay.
Like, I want you to interact with your bird and do what you feel and do what you see from her, because you know bird body language.
Yeah.
So just read it and adjust and flow and...
Yep.
And I'll just correct the tiny little things.
Yeah.